All right, Mr. Clean is here in the studio working, doing some editing. So I won't do my normal in-house big studio production intro. All right, Mr. Clean is on the scene here at the farmer's market. People are congregating by the water. The vendors are going wild over here. Not really wild, but people are kind of lackadaisically sitting. And it's in season. All right, Gavin is serving some food over here.
Well, I make 10, but
wide array of things going on. I think I'm going to get myself some fresh stuff for salads. So I'll rejoin you when I make my selection as to which vendor I shall choose for the Mr. Clean Show. Yes! Choice on my friend here that does woodworking. There's a wide array of stuff here. They're selling some stuff, like hotcakes, right? Or no?
Play with trees.
It's what?
Play well with trees.
Good. I'd have to get close because the, and you do the work, right?
Both do the work.
All right! Oh, I didn't mean to be.
He cuts the trees and he brings them home and we play with them.
All right, there's a wide of the cool plaques. These are could be plaques or they could be just cool coaster things or whatever. I'm extrapolating.
Coasters, cutting boards, you name it, you do it.
Yeah. Oh, look, some of these are so beautiful. Just the rings of the trees.
If the tree gets sick, send it to our house. We'll take care of it.
Oh, nice.
Right?
Yeah. Oh, they got little mini ones. Oh, this is when you get around to it. Yeah. Oh, there you go.
I take it you've been having fun with your show.
Yes, I have. Oh, jewelry even. Nice. And everything that you want on the Mr. Clean Show. Even stuff over here coming out of the back of the vehicle. So this is going to be every time at the farmer's market, right?
We get sick, we make fun things out of it.
Nice.
There you go.
Thank you for the interview. It's been going a few years.
It's doing well.
It is. I'm just coming back into production because I've been in the hospital and all that kind of thing. But now it's coming back. Everything you want to see.
Well, as we go to the hospital and get out of it again.
Yeah. I made it out this time. Never again.
don't need your war machines. I don't need your ghetto scenes. Gully lights get hypnotized. Sparkles over us is eyes. Now we're on. Get away.
All right, Mr. CleanN is here on the scene. I have my cameraman, Tony, here, and we're here for the biking protest. But what the hell? No one is even here. Where are they? It's exactly 4:45.
Where is the where's the biking protest?
Put a bike lane in there on Cayuga, but the people that organized the protest, all the people that mouth off about it on the internet, is not even here. What's going on? But
you know what we do have? Our bikes. There are some bikes here, and the bikes are protesting because they want more room.
That's why they're sitting here idle. If there's a bike lane, they'd be able to go down Cayuga.
And we are here in front of Ithaca City Hall.
So we will,
Ithaca, New York, that
we
is.
We will join later.
We're not in Greece.
With when the people actually get here. But if they don't show up, we will leave.
Yes!
Everything you want to see. Biking, Tony the cameraman, everything! Yes!
Not, but okay,
just
now it's on,
it
record.
Wasn't on record.
I hope I didn't miss that.
What do you think?
I think there should be one, and like he said, it would be great if it was on top of the buildings, but to be realistic, obviously we couldn't do that.
Come on, Skytram, Skytram. Oh, I don't know.
But anyway, good to see you.
You too. Hi.
All right, thank you.
Have a good day, guys.
All right, thanks. Well, gee, and
it is on
record.
The whole biking issue.
Yeah, the heck with bicycles. Screw you, bicycles.
Oh, wait, this is...
No, wait, that's my bicycle.
I thought it was. I had a bicycle
stolen. I was scanning for my old Panasonic,
remember,
but it's not here.
Remember, always out in the camp. So that's what Basil had the problem with. He's like, no, it's not the subject matter. It's me.
You mean like...
It's a Mr. CleanN show. It's not the biking show or the... Because it doesn't matter if I'm interviewing God or a block of wood. It's all about my interactions with that interviewee. Yes, the Mr. CleanN show. All right, I found something. Cheese. People are now buying some. I sampled a few. Unfortunately, I don't have my cameraman with me, so I couldn't get that all on film. But I mean, I talked to the lady. She said she actually, like I said, how do you treat, do you pet the cows? She said, yes, you do pet them. They're very friendly. And so this is a cool thing where I assume by her reaction that they really take care of the cows. Although I see they're selling some bacon and meat, so some of the critters must go to slaughter, but these people are flocking, I tell you.
People tell me that a lot. Yeah. Our cows are, we actually milk from the cows, and they're cheap, they're milk from the cows.
looks like the customers have now died down, so I can actually get an interview with the lady. I picked out my cheeses, and I think I'm going to get some meat as well.
We're gonna try that next week. We'll come back for.
So this will be 6 for this, so 13 for all of it. Is that okay?
So your farm is close
by? In Ovid, we're about halfway up the lake on the west side.
Nice.
I need to go steal some stuff.
Oh, maybe I have two.
So I've actually selected this.
Thank you very much.
Sure, thank you.
Butter. Oh, wait, I don't even know what it is, so I'm going to wait to talk to the lady, and here she's finally available, and I'm going to join the mailing list. Oh, wait, I shouldn't show that on TV. Okay, now, I'm going to get these two things. That's
okay.
Two for...
That's
and
10.
Then this is...
Those are 8 for a half pound.
Cool.
And 5.
So this is the goblin, and this is the aged Swiss.
Yes.
And these are just chunks of something else.
Yes, they're pre-cut pieces of the aged Swiss, so great for snacking.
So tell me about your farm.
We have a dairy. We milk brown Swiss cows. We're in Ovid, which is up on between Seneca and Cayuga Lakes, about halfway up the lake. I'm actually the 12th generation of my family to farm, but I...
Whoa! 12th generation?
I started my own farm, so I'm the first one on my farm. Started from scratch and have built everything that we have. And right now we make cheese, and we're working on making yogurt and bottling our own milk also.
Nice! How are you able to do it? I know... Actually, my grandfather was a dairy farmer, and they weaseled him out because it's like dairy leave, but there was like some weasel thing where they gave him milk certificates, and then the price dropped out of it, and they were like killing off all the family farmers. It must be hell to try to keep a family farm going, is it?
Yeah, it's a lot of work, and that's why we have gone into making our own products, so that we have some control over our prices and get a little more of the food dollar, because otherwise there's a lot of layers in the middle, and this is what we are doing to survive as a small family farm.
Yeah, this is probably the only way you did it, to sell direct, right?
Yes.
All right, so I'm going to get these products here, these cool, what are these?
This is called Morning Glory. It's a soft, fresh cheese, like a cream cheese, but better.
Two different varieties. Then an aged Swiss that's aged for a year, 14 months?
A year.
And, oh no, that was
the
different.
That's the aged Swiss. This is the Goblin, which is a cheddar Swiss blend.
And this is the aged Swiss.
Yep.
Excellent. Everything you want to see for the Mr. Clean Show. Yeah!
Thank you.
Was all it said. soldier rides away.
Everything you want to see.
So, nobody's show. What the hell?
Okay, Daniel. Daniel's one of the guys, and then there's this other city planner guy.
Come on. What the hell?
There's no one in there? I thought I smelled somebody in there. All right, shall we go take a look at Cayuga Street and see if there's room?
Yeah.
Let's go see if there's room for a bike lane.
Really, it's
why
a two
not?
Lane. It's a two-laner. So,
why you mean not? Like Tulane University?
It's a two-laner, so block to fuck the whole, you don't need two lanes for cars.
You
make
don't?
One lane a car.
Have you ever driven on Cayuga Street?
Well, like I say, it's block all of Ithaca.
It used to be two ways, but then they made it a one-way street. And there's still not enough room.
Yeah, kill off the parking.
Well, just, no, that, I know, cut down all the trees.
You got two.
Cut the trees down and put a bike lane, or put the bike lane on top of the trees.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, it's Mr.
No,
Clean
to,
Show, so I'm gonna
to
shut
cut
up.
Down the trees. There's plenty of room.
Nice to see you, Teresa. How are you? What do you think about putting a bike lane on this street?
A protected bike, I need it.
Or do you think we should put it on top of the buildings, like above the...
Yeah, overpass.
Yeah, like an overpass.
Yes, yes. These guys try to run me down.
Seriously, they do. They try to run you down.
Yeah.
But... They have, well, one guy, well, he messed up my shoulder really bad at one point.
You got a second?
But it's, you know, yeah, no, I think they should have, yeah, like an overpass.
Uh-oh, he's expressing
Thanks,
opinion
Teresa. It's nice. I'm helping him with his videography. Aha.
No, I don't want to get videotaped.
Oh, you don't? Oh, sorry
no.
About that.
Okay.
Oh,
you
will edit it out.
Yeah.
Maybe good to see
time.
You.
Yeah, good to see you too. Y'all have a good day.
All right,
fine,
take
guys.
Care.
Yes, good to see
well,
you.
Well, thanks.
Bicyclists, I know they can't be in the street all the time. It's not safe for them. But they're always behind, they're always, and if I move to the side like this, they're gonna run, you know, run into me. But they have a bell. I wish they would have a bell on their bikes.
As a pedestrian?
No.
Yeah, the reason we have to go on the sidewalks is because the cars are running us off the road.
Oh, I know that. That's why I just... Yeah.
I thought you were saying cars were trying to hit you while you were biking.
No, but I'm saying that, I know how dangerous it is to ride in the street. I know how dangerous that is.
Yeah, I've done
it in Manhattan. It's crazy.
I got driven onto the sidewalk one time by somebody who was looking
but
that
honest
way.
But honest to God, I have so many times.
We were just checking.
I'm shocked. The bike is right behind me. If I move to the side,
the other side.
Get hit.
Not on your side.
They need a bell to warn that they're behind you. When you work in the food industry, you have to stay behind you.
You know? I think you're right.
Yes. I'm thinking that the proposal they have is like they even have a separate like little things to keep the cars away from the whole thing.
Okay, wait. So they're gonna put divide the sidewalk.
Right in the street.
Oh, okay.
Actually, I wish the people that were organizing this thing were here. Like, come on, Daniel and the other guy, if you're gonna do a bike. Activist thing going, you gotta show up.
No,
anything
saying,
more to say? This is what it's about. It's for television. All right. The cameraman's trying. What do you think about a bike lane?
It's kind of tight. It's kind of tight.
For Cayuga Street.
According to the guy, he says he's planned it all out and there's plenty of room.
All right,
measurements, everything.
Thanks.
Yeah, but yeah, I see what you're
saying. I think it's kind of tight. My suggestion is to put like sort of a sky tram, like a, Teresa called it an overpass. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. They should like mount it on the top of the buildings.
It would be really easy to just extend these buildings right here, those shorter ones.
Yeah.
Just kind of have it all level over there, so you have a some sort of up structure there, sort of like an escalator for bikes.
That's...
And you can just ride along the top of the buildings. maybe rappel down onto the top of the Sunoco.
Uh-huh.
And then rappel down to where those wood chips are. And there you go.
Yeah, that sounds
maybe
like
that is. I thought he was just being facetious, but it might actually be a good idea.
Yeah, there's your idea. Thanks. That's like 10 cents per something. Give me 10 cents for every view here.
Every jump off the roof.
On the clip on 10 cents, and every second you play that video, I'll make 10 cents.
You want to...
I'm going out to see if the protesters are there. All right, no protesters have shown up. Processors here, and it's already way past the time. Daniel, come on. If you're going to organize a thing, you got to actually show up. City planner guy, Kevin, I think it was. If you're going to talk about making a bike lane, you got to actually show up for the event. Come on, people, get with it. But Mr. Clean was here, and that's the important thing. All right, we'll join you later with some other issues.
I don't know.
All right, we're strolling down the walkway and we see an ad for the mayor. I particularly like the mayor. He brought back fireworks to Stewart Park. He's fixing up the place. Seems like he's pretty cool, and I'm a Republican. So that's pretty cool. What do you think?
I'm just trying to make sense of this frickin' thing. And yeah, we know you, Svante. You shop downtown. That's not very specific. It could be Walmart. Which doesn't really say that much. Are you saying that you don't shop at the mall? You never go to the mall? And where are you shopping these days? Here, give me this thing for a second. Are you shopping in this frickin' mess? Is this where you're shopping? Can we just get the commons back, please? So we have a common place to be with each other. And if we want to protest, or celebrate, that's what our community needs. Yes!
Feeling better now that I understand just what you require, and I know that I'll win cause I can. Knowing that you set the standard for me,
I'm getting good.
Welcome.
Well, thanks for making sure that we weren't causing trouble or like endangering your shot.
Look, there's a cool shot.
Yeah, it's like,
here.
What are they filming? What?
Sunny Days. I don't even know what it is, but we're going to go see what it is. This gentleman here.
Well, you go ask the owner first, all right? Go ask the owner if it's all right.
Okay, now Tony has qualms of filming without permission, and that's the whole, like, as I've told so many people, if you don't want to be filmed, then you better watch out, my head's gonna come popping out of your toilet. All right, this gentleman, look, they have some cool stuff. I love New York mugs, art space here. Ooh, some nice artwork. Excellent. Sweet. Oh, the owner is in here, and I assume, even if it doesn't, I think I recognize her. Hi. I'm just doing a little feature. I was doing a bike protest thing, but then we were out here and thought, hey, is this a cool shop or what?
It's a pretty cool shop.
All right. So this will be on the Mr. Clean Show.
Okay.
That's the owner. We have some t-shirts here. We have Tony that has qualms about filming. We have
filming. Just
it's what, especially if somebody doesn't want to be filmed. That's the most entertaining thing.
Oh, no.
Okay, now we have. Oh, look at this phone! Look at that. That is cool.
These are pretty nice phones. Yeah, they're clocks, actually.
We might bring Tony in as
it's
a in front of the camera
hard
support element.
Is, but they are some kind of a clock. But the phones are set on different times. That never happens with cell phones.
Oh, I just realized they were clocks. Glad you pointed that out.
They're
it's like,
they're clocks.
I don't know. I'm all cut up and filming. Cool glass here. Nice old vintage signs. Bags of cash. Ooh, of old 78 LPs turned into clocks. Nice.
10-inch records, man. It's been a while since I've seen a 10-inch record.
Whip out my big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues. Mine's only 8, so it wouldn't work for the 10-inch song, but Aerosmith was pretty cool, don't you think?
Aerosmith, yeah, you know, that was never quite my cup of tea. But
some fragrances, soaps. So if you get a chance to come by and check, they even have honey.
I'm enjoying the local honey. I almost bought honey at Tops, and I went, nah, I should get local honey because that stuff is probably from Brazil and has nothing to do with my local allergens.
Plus, you want raw, unfiltered.
That's right.
And it looks like this is... yes, raw, natural, raw, delicious. Excellent. Yeah.
It might be filtered, but it still has the essential ingredients.
All right, we may come back here and cover the shop at another time, but it's located right here on the corner of Green and Cayuga, where the bike protest was supposed to be. Sunny Days are here again, the skies above are clear again.
here with carpenter bees, and my friend Tony's. Here's a whole nest, or not a whole nest. It looks like a limited population, but one is coming out, and another one is feeding.
So when you had to eat it, you had to be careful. Not lick salmonella. Packaged.
I'll lick the battery.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
and that's how they hunt their prey.
I know people who
lie. You know what I mean? And then they wrap them up in the web and it's like storm for future eating.
Yeah, and then
they eat that. Carpenter bees. They're not bumblebees, they're carpenter bees. They look similar to bumblebees, but they're slightly smaller and more black. But they're all over. It's a high population density thing going on here for the Mr. Clean Show.
Gas stations at the top of the hill.
Now it's been proposed time and again too that big business is behind things like this, and that would represent a capitalist approach. But what you're saying is we're heading toward a socialist approach based on the scenario.
You have to understand the difference between capitalism, socialism, communism, what all of these things really mean. You have to understand that what the difference is between right wing and left wing. People, they use these phrases all the time, and they don't even know what these things mean. And it's just incredible to me to hear a socialist calling someone else a Nazi. Because Nazi means National Socialism. So here's a socialist calling a right-wing guy a Nazi, when what he should be calling the right-wing guy is anarchist. People on the right want no control. Mm-hmm. They're really anarchists.
So okay. They would, in theory then, or in fact, be in opposition to this ultimate movement.
Yes.
Whereas in appearance, they would be the ones behind it.
Well, when you have a misunderstanding of what the terms mean, yes.
Okay.
Right wing, on the far right, is total anarchy. They don't want anybody controlling anything that they do, and they believe that people are responsible enough that the world can exist without government.
Okay.
Or the very minimal government that it would take to... On the far left, on the other hand, they believe that the government should be in total control and should be supply man with all of his needs.
Well, creating a whole society that's dependent.
Right. A republic is somewhere in the middle. It's governance by laws. Laws are decided by representatives who are elected by the people. And according to the theory, the representatives will do what is right, whether they get elected or not, because it's not really a democracy. A democracy is far left. People don't understand. We don't live in a democracy. This country is not a democracy. It is a republic. A democracy is ruled by the mob. The mob always votes themselves every kind of benefit that they can vote themselves. And whenever you do that, it means large, tremendously overpowering government in control.
They vote themselves into dependency.
That's it. They vote themselves into a dictatorship is what they do, where they lose all of the benefits that they intended to vote themselves into in the first place.
Okay.
And democracies are extremely dangerous to minorities, because if the majority of people don't like you, they're going to vote that they kill you, and they can, you know, that's it. Democracies are dangerous. Democracies are socialists. Democracies are communism. That's what communism is. The definition of communism is everybody doing according to their talents and receiving according to their need. And it doesn't work. We already know it doesn't work. Men, by his inherent nature, is greedy.
Mm-hmm.
So those at the top always end up having everything, and those at the bottom end up having nothing in communism. Socialism is different. Socialism usually ends up in a dictatorship, in a very controlling dictatorial government, which even owns the people that it governs, so that those who live in fear of not having are provided for what they need, and in turn they worship this oppressive government. Socialists are children who went out into the world took a look around and said, I can't handle it, and went home to Daddy.
Okay.
Daddy, protect me. Daddy, feed me. Daddy, loan me your car. Daddy, tuck me in at night. Socialists are scared little children who are irresponsible, can't stand on their own two feet, and need Daddy to take care of them.
Okay.
Okay?
Now we got the...
But what happens when you go home to Daddy and Daddy does all these things for you? Tell me.
Well, you never leave the home. You've not got no reason to. In other words, if you're being provided for in that way.
You're being provided for, but what does it mean? Doesn't it mean that you have to do what Daddy tells you to do?
True.
Doesn't it mean you have to be in when Daddy tells you to be in? Doesn't it mean that you can't drive the car to the next town if Daddy tells you you can't? Doesn't it mean that if Daddy tells you to take out the trash, you better take out the trash? Are you beginning to understand the concept? Mm-hmm. When you ask for favors from Daddy, you have to give up freedom in return.
Okay.
So socialism always leads to repression of liberty, freedom, equality, all of those things fly out the window so that you can have free health care,
mm-hmm.
so that you can have a place to live but you don't have to pay the rent, so that you can have food given to you by the state. And that's where we're headed. Right in this country right now, we're almost totally socialist, and now people are screaming for a national health care policy.
Right.
Health care insurance.
Now, the other aspect, once again, I'd like to go into is the anarchy or the right wing, which we just into that similar.
Anarchists believe that they can be responsible, that they won't hurt other people.
Okay.
That your freedom never ends until it begins to infringe upon someone else's freedom. And that no one should have any control over that. That there should be no speed limits on the highways.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is that, again, just like on the socialist side, you have people over here that are human. And human condition means that ultimately somebody's not going to be responsible. That they're going to drive too fast when they've had too much to drink and they're going to kill innocent people. The answer is a balance. You know, the law of the universe says this. It's a law of physics, really, and everybody can understand it. For every action, there is an equal but opposite reaction. There can be no good unless there is evil. There can be no man without a woman. You understand
right.
the concept?
Based on that, the theory of a utopia here on Earth is corrupt. Right away.
Absolutely.
It goes against the laws of physics.
It goes against the law of the universe that there must be two opposing forces all the time in every instance, because that's what makes the universe work.
Mm-hmm.
That's what makes everything work. What we need to do is stop trying to go way over here and establish some utopia of freedoms, or way over here to establish some repression of freedom so that we make sure that we got something on the table to eat.
Mm-hmm.
And strike a balance between the two that works.
It's CleanN here. They've started already this morning. And all of these clouds across here. Up there are also dissipated chemtrails as well. This little phone video doesn't really pick it up too well, but wish I had some anti-aircraft missiles.
Demons always want to more. kiss and a good hot Quaker Oats breakfast, the best school day start you can give your youngster. For just as his soul is nourished by a hug and a kiss, so will his young body be nourished by a good hot breakfast of Quaker Oats. Yes, you'll keep him bright and alert for classwork, happy and healthy through the morning's active play with a nourishing hot breakfast of Quaker Oats with that wonderful oatmeal protein. Naturally, youngsters look forward to an occasional change for breakfast. So one morning, try strawberries blended right in while the oatmeal cooks. Another time, blend in pineapple or tangy applesauce. The recipe for delicious oatmeal and fruit blended is right on the package. Yes, it's so nice having a mother who starts the school day with a hug and a kiss and a good hot oatmeal breakfast made with Quaker Oats or Mother's Oats, the same high-protein oatmeal.